of conversation. Now, we have new people that had no homework. So, what do? You're going to help them with the conversation, what you did. Is that funny, Paul? So, once we get up to that point, we're going to do a game first and do some vocabulary, but I would like, after that, for you to get together and practice conversation, and then we'll move on to chapter 2. Do you have books?
Yes, I
have. Did you get books? You have books?
No, they came down.
No? In the office. In the office, they have books. Oh, in the attendance.
That is not your card.
Oh, okay. I'll get the other one.
Yeah.
While you guys are with the homework. But let's do. So, the words on the left side have to match the words on the right side somehow. So please repeat after me. Deal.
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 Town.
Town.
Momentary.
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 Moment.
Momentary.
Terry. Momentary.
Momentary.
Not tarry, but momentary.
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 Palace.
Palace.
Chums.
Chums.
Paparazzi.
Paparazzi.
Union.
Union.
Stick.
Stick.
Berg.
Berg.
Bargain.
Bargain.
Ephemeral.
Ephemeral.
Tourniquet.
Tourniquet.
Pals.
Pals.
Confederate.
Confederate.
Throne.
Throne.
Cameras.
Cameras.
Good. Not camera, but camera.
Camera. Camera.
Yeah, it looks like camera. It looks like three, but it's two.
Cameras.
Camera.
Camera.
Cameras.
Cameras.
One camera.
One camera.
Yeah. Not camera. Camera.
Camera.
Camera.
Camera.
Okay, which one goes with which?
Paparazzi.
Huh?
Paparazzi.
Paparazzi?
Camera.
Yeah, and camera. Paparazzi goes with camera. What are paparazzi? Anybody?
Like some group of photographer. Photographer.
Yeah, photographer of famous people.
Yes.
Anyone who's famous. Not nice people. Very rude people. They take pictures without permission.
Mm. Palace. Throne.
Yeah, throne.
Throne.
What's a throne?
Throne. It's a group of love.
What's a palace?
It's a place for the king or the queen.
Where they live, right?
Right.
The throne is where they sit.
Oh.
Where they sit. It's also slang for toilet.
Oh. Really?
Throne.
Toilet.
It's American slang for toilet.
Really?
Yeah.
How can you say that? I want to go. I'll go to throne.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. We don't have a king in my country.
Oh.
Or a queen, like in England or Thailand or whatever. But, yeah, you go to the throne. Right, where's the throne?
Okay.
Town.
Town. No. No, they side clock. Side clock. Yeah. Left and right.
Union. Confederate.
Union?
I guess.
Yeah. And no idea?
I have read about it. Confederate.
Do you have any idea? It's American history.
Really?
Remember we had a war, the North and the South?
Right.
The North was the Union.
Mm-hmm.
The South was a Confederate. Like the group of states.
Mm-hmm.
The ones down South had slavery. The ones up North were against slavery.
Mm-hmm.
So we had the Civil War,
mm-hmm.
the Union and the Confederate. It kind of means group. Both of them mean group. Union means group, a group of things, a group of people. Confederate, a group of things, a group of people.
Town.
Town. And which one?
Bag.
Bird. Yeah. Town and bird. They kind of mean the same thing. It's like a small city. A bird. Does anyone have a dictionary? Phone?
Yes, we have.
What is bird?
A city or town. Informal.
There you go. A city or town. And then if you look up town, it'll say burg or city. Right?
Deal.
Deal.
Bargain.
Yeah.
Let's make a deal.
Yeah, let's make a bargain.
Mm-hmm.
Let's bargain. Let's make a deal. That's a good deal.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good bargain. Same thing. Where can you get a good bargain on electronics?
Mm-hmm.
Where can you get a good bargain on electronics in Pattaktani?
Sears.
Yeah.
They have a lot of good deals there.
Oh, yeah.
They have a lot of bargains. Yeah, pal. Chum and pal.
Oh.
Chums and pals. They're friends.
Friend.
Good.
Friend.
Good. Right. Am I saying that right? In Thai? Good.
Yeah.
Friends. Yeah, you say, we're pals. We're good friends. We're good chums. Pals. Chums. Friends. Buddies. Buddies.
Buddy.
He's my buddy. He's my chum. He's my pal. He's my friend. All the same thing. Chum also means to spend time with your friend. If you chum around with somebody, it means to spend time with. Yeah.
Momentary.
Ephemeral. Yep. Ephemeral. What, Mo, do you have what does ephemeral mean? Momentary just means not for a long time, for a small amount of time. But ephemeral, I think it's the same thing, but I think it's more important.
Lasting a very short time.
Lasting a short time. Yeah, momentary
short
is short time.
Time,
ephemeral is short time. And stick and tourniquet.
Tourniquet.
Ah. Tourniquet is usually a piece of cloth. Like if I'm bleeding and I have blood coming out, I take my put it around and I make it tight. That's a tourniquet. And you use if I break my arm, I put a stick and a tourniquet so I can't move it. You know what I mean?
Tourniquet.
Q-U-I-T? Yeah, so that's a stick and tourniquet. You have right now?
My veins.
Did you hurt yourself?
My thing.
You hurt yourself? You break
my.
Oh, okay. This one. Oh, yeah. We call that like a cast. Cast.
Good
evening. Cast. Stick and turn it. Okay. Let's see, how are we going to do?
You were here for homework. You were here.
Let's see. They don't have any more copies of this. Well, maybe we can work together and we can come up with one conversation that everyone can look at from the homework from 2 weeks ago. Was, you weren't here, but the homework was to make a dialogue kind of similar to what we did in class. I know everybody probably has something different, but how about we work together and make one dialogue, and then we can break off and practice for a little bit, and then we're going to go into chapter two. So let's start with, I think the first thing we should start with is a greeting, right?
Right.
What's the first thing you say to somebody?
Hello. How have you been?
Hi. All
right. How do you do?
Hi. All
right.
Hi. All
right.
Hi.
How are you today?
Hi, what else?
Hi.
Hi.
How are you? Hello, hi. Who are you? Hi. How about B? We'll go to the next person. B. Hi.
Hello.
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 Hi. Hello. Hello. Okay.
Okay.
What's up? Yeah, there you go. Hey. Well, let's see. When you meet somebody for the first time, you don't usually say, what's up?
Do you?
You say, what's up if you know the person. But here, these are two people that don't know each other.
How do you do?
Ah, okay. Excuse me. Excuse me. What did you say?
I see you.
Ah.
Have you met before?
Have you been? And we're at the temple, right?
Right.
Where are we? At the temple? At the coffee shop? At the bus station?
At a temple.
At the temple, okay.
Right.
Have you been here before?
Before.
Have you been here before? That means before now. Right? B. How about we say no? Because it's a tourist,
right?
Or somebody coming in. So person A lives or works at the temple.
Right.
Person B will be like
tourist,
a tourist or a falan. Somebody that looks like me that has hair. Excuse me, have you been here before? No. Oh. How do you say no? Why do you answer?
I haven't.
Yeah.
I haven't.
Have you been? No, I have not.
It's beautiful. So good. Real name.
welcome to Dhammakaya Temple.
Yeah, that'll work.
Get on the point.
Yeah, exactly. I want to get to the point. Get to the point. Now, do you say what, or do you say just Dhammakaya?
Is it the same meaning, or should,
well, I don't
how
know.
Should you say for the foreigner? Which
for
one is?
For a foreigner,
temple,
I think
right?
You would say the whole thing, right? What, bra?
Dhammakaya.
Or just Dhammakaya?
Dhammakaya temple.
Dhammakaya temple.
So do I say what, bra, Dhammakaya, or do I just say Dhammakaya?
Dhammakaya.
What, bra?
What does mean temple in Thai? What in Thai does mean temple?
Right.
Right.
Temple.
It's
temple.
But I'm not sure they can understand what.
That's okay. When people are traveling in Southeast Asia, they hear all kinds of things they don't understand.
Uh-huh.
Seriously. Like,
uh-huh.
What?
What?
They might ask, what?
Uh-huh. What does mean
what?
Okay.
Oh! Song Chai!
Oh, long time.
Long time no see.
Glad to see you back.
Welcome to what Pratamakai. Thank you. So let's you say welcome and then let's give a question.
May I have your name, please? Or how have you been?
Mm.
How may I help you?
Hi. Hello. Excuse me, have you been here before? No, I have not. It's beautiful. Welcome to my friend. Okay. Yeah. So you want to ask for some kind of help?
Yeah. Do you know the way to go to the chapel?
Okay.
Do you know
how to get?
Do you know how to get
to the chapel? Is that something you would say to somebody? Like if I never met you before, right? Welcome to what type of guy?
Are you working here?
No, because you're talking to the tourist.
Uh-huh. Glad to see you here.
Oh.
Something like that?
Yeah. I guess it doesn't have to be a question. Because I don't think they would be asking about a specific place yet.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Because the topic we're going to get into is what? We want to get to Buddhism pretty quick,
yeah.
Right? We've already said hello. Have you been here? It's beautiful. Welcome to Wat Dhammakaya. How about this? Do you have any questions?
Oh.
Right? Welcome to the temple. Do you have any questions? Because you want to offer your help.
Mm-hmm.
So someone's coming. Welcome to Wat Dhammakaya. Do you have any questions?
Yes.
Yes.
I have. Yes. How do I leave? Where's the bus stop? Where's 7? 70 tonight.
Yes.
Do you have any questions?
Another question?
Yes, I do. First question a foreigner might ask.
Um,
They've never been to the temple before. All of a sudden, they're here.
This place?
Something about the founder. Welcome to Lockdown with Guy. Do you have any questions? Yes, I do. Thanks for asking. How about we say when? When?
When?
When?
You think?
When?
When?
I'm wondering what kind of question would I ask? Maybe something a little more general. So notice you're answering a question with a question. Can you tell me about the temple?
What would you like to know?
What would you like to know? That's the same thing as saying yes. What do you want to know? You don't have to say yes.
Yes.
And then we can go to his question.
Who's the father of the temple?
Yeah. That's good. Two questions at one time.
Who
founded the temple? Do you know who founded the temple and when?
Chan.
Everyone have different answer?
The father of the temple is the
Nanchan. Gen.
The Grace Master
Nanchan.
Well,
Grace
the
Master.
The father is Grandmother Chan Mundu.
Grace Master Chan. None.
Sure. But we say sure and then we answer.
Sure.
What was the first word you said?
Father.
Father?
Father.
Oh,
father.
You have new.
Yes.
Father.
I see. Sifa. That's your new name, Sifa. When I was young, we didn't have colors. We just had metal. No colors. Not fun. Do you know who founded the Temple of Wind? Sure. So I would say something like, back in, meaning, and then I want to give a year. Back in, what year was it? And not the Buddhist temple, not the, if it's a Quran, you want to give the other day. You don't want to give 2000 something. They won't know what that means. That could mean 1 year, they don't know. So you have to say 19 or 18. What year was it founded in? You know? What year?
CCB.
45.
1970?
Yeah, 1970.
Oh, that's the year I was born.
Oh.
I'm very young. Thank you. Ah, you get an A. Oh my God. Okay. Sure. Back in, way back. No. Back in 1970.
Back.
Now, what's the name? Grandmother.
Grand,
how would you say it?
The master Nanchan.
Yeah, the
okay.
The master.
The master
Nanchan.
Master.
Is that how you would spell it in English?
Nan.
Oh, the master nun.
Yeah.
Nun.
Chan.
C-H.
The name.
The master Nanchan. Founded, created,
founded.
I would say created the foundation. She created the temple, like what do you mean, the building? Or the organization?
She the leader with 10 people.
Was it a?
Built?
Sam. Create.
Did you say 10 people?
With 10 people.
So it was 11 total?
From about?
About?
Yeah.
About
10, if more. I don't know.
Not sure.
In the Yukman, we had that.
Buddhist. What were they called? Were they nuns? Were all of them nuns, or some of them monks, or?
People, not monks.
Oh, not monks. Just
only one monk is Nineteen sixty-nine.
So what was created in 1970?
Yeah.
No. What? No. Why? What? Not why. What? Not why. What? So I'm asking a question, but you think I'm saying a sentence. What was created in 1970?
Start building. Start picking the grounds.
Oh, okay. Ground was broke.
Uh-huh.
You break the ground.
Uh-huh.
That's what you call groundbreaking?
Groundbreaking. Oh,
let's
call
that. Yeah.
Small.
doesn't, it's not in the dictionary. No, it's not here. Sure, the Master Nung Chan and a small group of people broke ground for the temple in 1970.
The first part of the Nanchi Chan, the Hongju, with Longpo Tamashego.
That was in 69?
Yeah. We collect the land and we have the money for start construction. 2200.
But when was the groundbreaking?
1970?
Yes.
So when was the temple created?
Yes.
Not the idea, but...
With.
Because some try is saying that Boon Paul had the idea in 1969.
So, but... you mean... That is broken ground.
Yeah.
But should we say about the donator that donated?
Well, that's up to you. I mean, if I'm a foreigner and I say, when was this place created? Like, I have three or four different answers.
After they received the volunteer foundation money grant of Sun Tonawet family, we gave the many land.
Well, let's not make it too complicated. We should go back to 1970. Do you know who founded the temple and when? Two answers.
Yeah, the long answer.
The Master of Nung Chan and a small group of people broke ground for the temple in 1970.
About 1982. The first land was 1982.
Okay.
1992.
Uh-huh.
Inside,
you
was a chapel and a small
residence. All right.
You're
right. Same.
92. So we want to get into
about.
So we got who created the temple and when, and we want to get into like Buddhism now. We want to get into questions about Buddhism. Right? I mean, I think that's natural.
Is from Sean and Mo. Continue.
Sean and Mo?
Yeah, and then it's direct to the Buddhism.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Do you want to read it with Mo?
I thought that Sean come back.
Oh, okay.
And then see Mo, and he has something about not clear about defilement.
Oh, okay.
Like I asked you about desire. So it's direct to the Buddhism.
Okay.
There are someone new, so you can.
Yeah, well, what did you have next? I mean, what do you think, what you have, can we put that next? Somehow? We have what would the next question be? How would B respond to this?
Well,
you don't have a book, do you? You have
a book?
Oh, you don't have a book.
No, I have books.
I need this. But I need this.
Make it a while.
Maybe
they have in the office. Did you get one in the office?
No.
Did you get one of these in DLC?
I don't
know. Let's see if we have any.
tao lại
thank you,
thì con này mới đây buông cảm ơn
I interest in meditation.
Ah.
Can you tell me some more
yeah.
about meditate about meditation?
Meditation.
Okay. Can you tell me more about their religion?
Mm.
Or can you tell me more? Okay. Let's see. Interesting.
Meditation. Interesting meditation practice.
So it'd probably be better that you don't write as I'm writing. Curious about. Same thing as interested in.
Oh, nice.
Curious about and interested in, same thing. Because if I say interesting, I don't want to right away say interesting again. So I want to say something similar. Interesting. I'm curious about meditation also. No book smoked? Oh, they're coming? Thank you.
I think what do I need to know is A, right? What do I need to know? What do I need to know? What do I need to know?
Oh, what a gentleman. Gentleman. I forgot. So, interesting. I'm curious about and interested in, same thing. I'm curious about meditation. I'm interested in meditation. They mean the exact same thing. I'm curious about meditation also. What do I need to know?
What do I need to know?
What do I need to know?
What should I know, right?
Yeah, what should I know?
Mm-hmm.
What do I need to know? What should I know? I'm asking you, because I'm the Faran.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the foreigner. I'm the tourist.
Yeah, you're the tourist.
I'm a tourist that lived here for almost 6 years. What do I need to know? How do you answer?
Yeah.
Me. I want to know about meditation. I'm curious about meditation. What do I need to know?
You have to sit in the right person's room.
Do we want to go to how? Or do you want to talk about where meditation comes from? Or
I thought you would like to practice.
Well, I'm curious about it, meaning I want to know information.
Meditation
is mean to make yourself very calm by relaxing completely.
Okay. Meditation. Let me start with the wrong meditation, what did you say?
Meditation is mean to make yourself. Very calm. Very.
Meditation means to make yourself calm. Right? And?
Calm down. Calm.
Make yourself calm and?
Relaxing completely. Relaxing completely.
Meditation means to make yourself calm and to relax.
Relax. competing.
Notice the comma. The comma means you breathe when you're speaking. So meditation means to make yourself calm and to relax completely your body and mind.
How many kinds of meditation?
Wow, yeah. How many are there?
Two
kinds of meditation?
We have two types of meditation.
Oh, in Theravada? Is this Theravada? This is not Theravada. This is
Theravada.
This is Theravada. So there's two kinds?
Two kinds. In majority, two kinds. First, we keep the mind
inside and outside
the body.
There are two
types or method or kind. What kind of word do we want to use here?
Grace.
Ways. There are two ways to practice.
Two ways of meditation. Yeah.
There are two different ways to meditate. Are they two different methods? Two different methods? What's the first one?
To focus inside the body.
And what's the other one?
Focus outside the body.
And there are two.
Concentrate in the center
focus
of body.
Inside the body.
And concentrate outside.
Where outside? Everywhere.
Everywhere.
Such as fire, wind. But it's not the real, it's not the right way.
So two different, do I want to say method? Because you're focusing, both of them you're focusing, right? Mm-hmm. One you're focusing inside, the other one you're focusing outside. See, I don't have a book to go through, so I'm relying on you guys.
สมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธิสมาธ
Meditation means to make yourself calm and to relax completely your body and mind. Buddhism shows people the way to meditation. I'm trying to switch the topic into Buddhism.
Because.
Is that true?
Buddhism shows people the way.
Shows people the way to meditation.
And then the next question is.
What is the Buddhism?
What is the reason?
What is the teaching of Buddhism?
Ah.
Or what is the Buddhist teaching?
It's better to think about your next thought.
How about like this?
Buddhism?
That's a whole question right there.
Yeah.
Ooh, Buddhism?
Buddhism is one of the religions. Buddhism is one of the religions which created
Buddhism is the way of life.
It's one of the philosophy.
Buddhism by the Buddha.
For the people. Yeah, the temple.
About meditation, what do I need to know?
Meditation means to make yourself calm and to relax completely your body and mind. Buddhism shows people the way to meditation.
Buddhism?
Buddhism is a way of life for people here at the temple and throughout Thailand.
That sounds pretty good.
But my homework is Mo and Sean.
Mo and Sean? Mo, do you want to do her homework?
Can I read?
Yeah, I want to hear.
Well, hey.
Let me hear me and Mo.
So, start with Mo.
Okay, Mo.
Hello, Sean. It's very nice to see you again. You all come back.
You What did you say? You come. You come back. You've come back.
Oh, can I say you're back?
You can say you're back, or you can say you've come back. Yeah.
You're back.
You're back, or you've come back.
Hi, Mo.
Hi, Mo.
Hi, Mo. Great to see you here. May I ask you some questions?
Oh. Great to see you here. May I ask you some questions?
Mo said, sure. And John said, in my opinion, I think desire is something that brings enjoyment or satisfaction. But you told me we have to have extinct desire.
Extinct. Well, I would probably say extinguish.
Extinct
is, but it's not a verb.
Oh.
It's an adjective.
So I say we have to have.
We have to.
Have extinct.
No.
At least.
No, we have to. What is the word? The other word?
Desire.
Oh, we have to.
Because they are the defilement.
Mm-hmm.
Are they?
Extinction.
We have to make desire.
Oh,
extinct.
We have to get rid of desire.
Yeah, we have to get rid of desire.
We have to
there
get rid of desire because they are the defilement. Are they?
Yeah.
Yeah. So Mo said, not exactly. Desire are in two types. One direction is good. For instance, your desire is becoming Buddha.
Okay.
Yeah. So you try every way to accumulate merit to reach your goal.
Okay.
In Pali, we use the word different, and it is very clear in Pali. But in English, if your desire, in English we use desire, right? In English the same word. If your desire is you want to belong to the other assets or lovely things and try to steal them, it's a bad deed.
If you try to what? Steal them?
Steal. Steal.
Yeah, steal.
Steal them. It's a bad deed.
Mm-hmm.
You have to get rid of them or something like this.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And Chung said, thanks.
I understand now.
I go to Assembly Hall to see my friend.
I'm going to Assembly Hall. Do you want to come with me? Do I say
so
that?
So say you later. See you later.
So see you later.
No.
See you.
See ya.
Have a nice day. And Sean said, thanks. Bye for now.
Bye for now.
Goodbye.
Huh?
Mo said goodbye.
Bye. Very good. So you got very deep very quickly. You know what I mean? Deep. You got very serious.
So I just write, we have to get rid of.
Yeah. Yeah, get rid of. Yeah, to get rid of defilements. So you have one where you want to make merit. That's one way, right? To make merit, and the other way is to get rid of defilement.
Yeah.
And those are the two ways.
Yes, together.
Oh, and they go same time.
Uh-huh.
Interesting. Did you do your homework?
Yes, I do.
What did you have?
Oh. Hello, Born. Welcome to the Makaya Temple. I'm glad to see you.
Hello, who?
Born.
Who is that?
James Born.
Oh! I thought you said Born, like the Born identity.
No.
James Born.
Hi, Bandit. But it's a Thai name.
I know Bandit.
Yeah.
Loopy Bandit. I don't know where he is.
Hi, Bandit. Glad to be in here too.
With you.
I'm glad to be in here.
Uh-huh. I'm glad to be here. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Okay, but let me ask you some question. Sure, go ahead. Who is the father of Buddhism?
Uh-huh.
The father of Buddhism is the Buddha.
Uh-huh.
What did he teach?
What did he teach?
What did he teach? He taught the way of self,
love,
and good, and to get rid of from suffering.
Mm.
Wow, sounds very interesting. And how? Through meditation practice. Well, how many types of meditation? They have two types of meditation.
Uh-huh.
Firstly, meditation focusing inside your body. The other one is meditation focusing outside the body. Which one is better?
Ah, good question.
Well, I recommend you the first one.
Okay, I would recommend to you the first one.
I would.
Yeah,
I would recommend to you the first one.
Mm-hmm.
It's safe. The other one is risky.
Oh, risky. Safe and risky.
The first one is safe.
Which one's safe?
The first one.
Which is?
Focus in the body.
Oh.
Uh-huh. The first one is safe. The other one, focus outside the body, is risky.
Really? Now I'm interested. I'll do the second one.
Oh. You will take risk.
Huh?
High risk.
Oh, okay.
Meditation is not stock. Not, we have no high risk, high return. Huh?
Oh, okay. I thought one is like skydiving and one is like riding a bike.
Okay. I would like to learn meditation. Can you teach me? Well, I'm not the expert. Better I would take you to the teacher.
Oh, okay.
To my teacher.
Uh-huh.
Is it important to have a good teacher for the beginner?
Very good.
How nice. Shall we go now?
I like that. Excellent.
Take it easy, guy. let me check first when we can meet him. I'll let you know later.
Uh-huh.
All right. This was very nice to talk with you today. Keep in touch. Thank you very much for today. See you. See you later.
Uh-huh.
Bye bye.
Excellent.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, very good. You had the greeting. You got into talking about Buddhism and meditation, and then you had the farewell. Very good.
Excellent. Compliment.
What was the most important question out of your whole dialogue?
The type of meditation.
Uh-huh. Yeah, what was that question again?
How many types of meditation?
Oh, okay. How many types of meditation are there? Interesting. Good. Anybody else? Mo, did you do your homework? No? Yes? No?
Listen to you.
Should I show? No, I like both of them. Yours was excellent as well. So, what I would like to do is I would like you guys to practice this with each other. But I think we should come up, well, I think you can practice with each other. Because I don't want to do all the talking. So, let's see, how can we do this?